also the Nets, the New York Nets, are playing tonight. And it's going to be some very good basketball and some football, of course. And in the college thing, college basketball, UNC Chapel Hill, they're trying to come around, but Duke is trying to kick some major butt, too, you know?
Hey, Brian, why do you say New Orleans? Isn't it New Orleans?
Oh, no. See, I got a Southern girl here. Talk about New Orleans.
What Southern?
No, it's just like, yo, we're from New York. New Yorkers say, yeah, New Orleans, because that's how we kick it. But down south, they say,
but I'm used to how Lil Wayne says it. New Orleans.
Because Lil Wayne, can you read, kid? No, I'm just kidding. Come on, son. You know, I just mess with you, Wayne. I love you, kid. Come on. Lil Wayne's spitting up some new stuff, too. I like his stuff. This kid is pulling it on point. Weezy, you know, I think the same thing that happened to you. Hey, babe, bruh.
Yo.
When you get locked up for a minute, you change up, don't you?
Yeah, you definitely do.
Yeah, because Weezy can't.
I mean, you decide, you know, we ain't heard shit out of Weezy since he hit the bricks.
Well, the kid
is trying to walk the straight and narrow.
Not only is he walking the straight and narrow, but he's thinking about some shit, yo. I'm going to tell you something.
Yeah, that.
You know,
he's deep. That nigga got 500 tattoos, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? You can't be all tattooed up like that and not be deep within Atlantis. You know, and I'm
matter of fact, I heard Lil Wayne had a tattoo of himself getting a tattoo.
Really?
Seriously.
Where? On his back or like where?
Well, I don't know. I don't know.
I don't want to know.
I don't want to know. We keep that one under wraps, yo. But like I say, Weezy, man, like hitting up to you, man.
Yeah, I'm going to have you on Steve's Island no time.
Yeah, we're proud of you, though, kid. I'm going to tell you something.
Yeah,
you know, it's like, yo, you stepped out there, you know, and of course, I've listened to some of your music and some of your lyric content, man, and you're starting to steer people in the right direction, bro. And I'm gonna tell you something, that's what's up. Like Jay Z's been doing it. I mean, even Snoop's got his way of doing it. Like, you know, you got to read between the lines. That's the kind of way Wise Man X does it too. You got to read between the lines in most cases. But we dropping science, divine science, babe, bro.
Exactly. Yeah.
So what's up with you in that musicology? You in the lab?
Well, sit back, relax. We'll be right back with more Split Personality.
And enjoy the show.
That's what's up, baby. See you guys in the
future. DJ Divine Science, smoking up on the virtual wheel.
Yo, big shout out to Bushido Brooklyn.
By your hotel, take it to the motel, wholesale. Don't tell, won't tell. Baby, say I don't talk, dog. But she told on me, oh well. Take a picture with me, what the flick gon' do? Baby, stick to me, and I'ma stick on you. If you pick me, then I'ma pick on you. Be on the pussy, and I'm here to put this dick on you. I'm stuck on pussy, and
I'm going that way.
And I'ma get me a shot for the end of the night. Cause pussy is pussy, and baby, I'm pussy for life.
Rashida Rosa said Lil Wayne is still a mad face because he contradicts himself in most of his songs.
Just another tease for a dark and tea. Trying to get you up off this club. If it means spending on couple,
for example,
throw them off 30 stacks in the back, make it rain like that. Cause I fall from
the back.
In a low press, I'm sitting in the back in the smoker section. Bird's eye, I got a clear view. You can't see me, but I can see you. It's cool, we jet the movie set. Your pussy is wet, you're rubbing your back and touching your neck. Your body is moving, you're humping and jumping, your titties is bouncing, you're smiling and grinning and looking at me.
Girl, and while you're looking at me, I'm ready to hit the caddy right up on the patio. Who the patty to the caddy? Baby, you got a fatty, the type I like to marry. Wanted to just give you everything in the sanitary. Now I'm loving the way you shake your ass. Bouncing, got me tipping my glass. Normally don't get caught up too fast, but I got a thing for you. I see you whining and grinding up on that pole. I know you see me looking at you, and you already know.
Cranked any of Snoop's old hits, like, you know, Little Ghetto Boy along with Dre, and you know, that I Wanna Love You.
Yeah.
But man, I'm gonna tell you something. Snoop is a musical genius, man. That guy, man, damn. You know, if you listen to the intricacies of his music, like, you know, all the little ticks and horns and flutes, and, you know, hey, Snoop and Dre really understand how to use hypnotics in music to make you just fall in love with the groove.
Agreed. Listen, I'm going to tell you, like I said, Dr. Dre is on swole when it comes to them crazy beats. Yo, I'm going to tell you, N.W.A., Dr. Dre. You know what I'm saying? And I'm going to tell you something. It's like, you go back and listen to Fluff the Police. Son, that groove right there is so hard, son. And when you listen to, like, we this morning on FB Facebook, we were actually playing, we put out Snoop's The Riders on the Storm with The Doors, Jim Morrison and The Doors. Yo, that groove is unfadable, son. When you're listening to that groove right there, you understand that these people are grooveologists, Scientologists, scientists of sound.
Yes, they understand the science of groove technology.
Yo, that's what I'm saying. It's off the chisel.
And imagine listening to Dr. Dre through the new Dr. Dre headphones.
Ooh.
The sound quality.
That's what I'm talking about. Yo, I said, hey, Dre, it. Dr. Dre, check this out. Doc, send me a copy. We got the same.
Send us some headphones,
that's
too.
That's what I'm saying. We got the same birthday, kid. I'm telling you something. I'm always propping you up because I have to. You're the master. You're the doctor, son. I'm saying, but I'm also a doctor.
Yeah, he really could have named himself better, Dr. Drake.
That's what's up. Yeah, that's what's up. I'm telling
you. The doctor that told you to go see.
Yeah, that's
Drake. Right.
Or you could come
when
see
your beats
Dr.
wasn't
D.
doing too good. You know what I'm saying?
I'm serious. Your beats ain't working, son. I'm going to tell you something. Call Dre up. If his prices are too high, you call up me. Wise Man X up in the crib, son. This is X. I'll put the beats down because I'm going to tell you something. We're getting ready to drop a new CD. The Shine Your Light on Me CD is out. The new CD is going to be featuring Anna Monroe. Also, my baby brother, DJ Divine Science. It's going to be called I Love New York. Son, I'm telling you, it's going to be like off the queasy, son. Y'all gonna be fiending for it. It's gonna be harder than Scissorhands crack for DJs. I'm telling you, it's gonna be that mind crack, son. We're gonna have it for you. You know. Well, anyway,
hey, I actually like Scissorhands' last little single that he put on YouTube that people don't dance no more.
Oh, yo, son, he's been blazing since then.
Eddie, drop that shit.
Come on, I'm gonna tell you something. Eddie Scissorhands is no joke. If you don't know Eddie Scissorhands, DJ Eddie
Quinn
Scissorhands, let me inform you. I had a chance, opportunity to work with him on the latest CD and also DJ Charlie Casanova. It'll be processed out. Charlie, tell moms I love her, kid. I'm going to tell you something. Sizz is a master in the studio, dude. He's a master. And, he's got all kinds of new tracks. If you don't know Scissorhands, DJ Scissorhands, just all you have to do is Google Crooklyn Clan, like Brooklyn with the CrooklynClan.com. Check out the website. Pick up the mashups for 99 cents. Yo, that kid has got science, too. He's putting it together and putting it down, son, all right? All right?
I got a question for you, brother.
Go ahead, what's up?
And this is not just aimed at you. This is also aimed at all at our listeners.
Okay.
And, you know, feel free to call in, you know, text in, whatever you got to do. But I want to ask you, what exactly do you think makes good music?
Okay.
What is it? What is the science? What is it that makes music good?
Okay, that's a question for today. That's one of the questions for the next 15 minutes. Well, guys, we're throwing up a question at you. What do you think makes good music good? What makes music good to you? I mean, technically, is it the groove? Is it the lyrics? Is it the combination of both? Is it, female vocals? Is it male vocals? Is it harmony with vocal groups? You tell us what you think. The number to call.
Oh, gosh. Brian, it's your turn to say it.
718-633-0421. Give us a call, guys, and let us know what you think. What do you think makes music good? Okay, and we're throwing that question out to each and every one of you right now, guys. Also, okay, so what, Dee, pop it in the news, man, the tsunami. We can't talk enough about the tsunami and about Japan, man, and how we need to really consider, make sure you're saying your prayers and you're sending out some good energy to those people over there, man. 10,000 people right now missing. 10,000.
Think about that, bro.
No, in the morning they had 88,000 people missing.
88,000?
Yeah, in the morning. It was on the website.
Well, I heard that they were, maybe that was, maybe I think, no, you know something, I think you, because I know one day they said that they had rescued, the rescue attempts, they'd rescued like 10 to 12,000 people. And but there were like people missing. It's people missing all over the country. And of course, the nuclear power plants over there are also. They've shut down two of them. Okay, they're afraid.
One had a partial meltdown.
Yeah, they thought it's going to be like another Chernobyl over there, man.
They were walking around scanning little kids for radiation and stuff.
Yeah, man.
That was crazy.
That's it, man. I tell you. Imagine, bro. Thank God. You know, we are so fortunate that it hasn't happened over here, and that it won't, and it doesn't happen over here, man. Because, you know, like I said. Man, that's fugazi, bro, you know?
I heard, like, the people that were at the airport, they climbed to the top of the roof of the airport, and they got stranded there. They were just standing on the roof, surrounded by, like, a body of water.
Yo, that's crazy.
With no food, No heat, no nothing.
Have you seen any of the footage that's on the YouTube?
Yeah, I saw all the videos.
Yo, D, have you seen it? Have you seen the footage, man? Like when the waves were coming, they show when the actual waves were coming in.
Yeah.
I did see that. And bruh, you know, I really didn't realize that Japan technically is just an island. You know, I mean,
yeah, it's not that big.
Tokyo is actually an island like Manhattan is.
That's
you know,
bruh,
and where the earthquake occurred, it actually sent a ripple across the bay directly over the island of Tokyo, you know what I mean? So
yeah.
It's crazy.
Well, dude, and
it was just like a wave swept over the whole country, you know?
Yeah, and technically, because they have two nuclear power plants shut down and they're trying to cool the reactor in the third one, the major one that's over there, there's not enough electricity, man. People are suffering, dude. They're suffering over there, people. I'm trying to tell you something. We are lucky to be in the land of the living, in America, the greatest country in the world.
And the home.
You know, and once again, I mean, like, I'm not on a Snoop fetish today, but that's my dog. And Snoop did say, when he was talking about for the lupus thing, he was saying, listen, you know, when you get something, you got to give something back. And that's what's up, okay? I'm telling you, we have a lot here, man. We got to give something back. Make a little sacrifice, because sacrifice breeds success. You know what I'm saying? You feel me, man?
We got an answer for the what makes music great.
Okay,
the
Tito
Brooklyn Roll, the background vocals, the instrumentals, the lyrics, and the hook.
That's what's up. Yo, I'm going to tell you, Bushido, I couldn't agree with you more. It's a combination of those things in my eye. D, what do you think?
Well, I actually think that what makes music good to my ears is something that activates my senses, you know. I've heard good music that are hit records that, you know, sell 100,000 copies in 2 weeks,
mm-hmm.
you know, but they don't touch my soul. There's music that actually touches and actually activates your senses, like, you know, smooth jazz, you know, and it's the instrumentation and the clarity of the music and also the rhythm.
Correct. Has been detected.
Well, you understand?
I
go ahead. What
are you saying? I think that's what makes music good. Is actually the quality of the production, the rhythm of the music. Rhythm makes the music good to me.
Yeah. Well, you know, like I'm in agreement with you on that too. Because I tell you what, you go back to some old Earth, Wind & Fire songs, man. Like, have you ever listened to Sun Goddess, Earth, Wind & Fire, Ramsey Lewis, man? I mean, it's like hypnotics that takes you away. Your body feels the groove, and all of a sudden, you are actually floating in like a different space. And of course, they say, it's been documented, that the what happens is, when you're listening to good music that makes you feel good, and you feel good about it, it sets off the dopamine in your brain. It's like putting a shot of good energy, and the feel-good chemicals that are inside of your body are activated in your brain, which is called dopamine, and the dopamine that's in your brain from natural things that make you feel good, from even sex, you know, a little bit of herbalics, you know, the things that make you feel good, but especially music. When you hear nice sounds and good music, it sets off the dopamine in your brain, and it makes you feel better, and it also continues to help to build your health. So listening to good music is actually healthy.
Actually good for you. And I guess that's the correct answer. What makes music good is the music that actually helps your brain release dopamine.
That's what
makes music good.
Yeah, because I'm going to tell you, when you got that dopamine kicking off, yo, I'm telling you, son.
You feel like you can conquer the world,
that's what's sad about the illusion of actual substance abuse, man. Because people who are on the substance, man, they start feeling like they can conquer the world, but they don't realize it, you know.
They can't even climb a mountain.
I'm serious. They can't even get a heart attack. So I'm hoping Charlie Sheen don't get that bust a hard muscle, man. You know what I'm saying? You know? But I tell you what, like I say, going back to good music, what makes music good, I'm in agreement with Bushido Brooklyn, because that's like he says, you know what I'm saying? It's the instrumentals, the lyrics, the background. All those things are vitally important, man, to make not just hit records. I mean, your hit records are built on hooks, and there are formulas. You know, no rules, but formulas. And, you know, when you know how to, like Quincy Jones, who does it better? Quincy works with any artist, and all of a sudden, it's like, it's on blaze, you know? And a lot of producers...
Yeah, no doubt.
Yeah, Dr. Dre. If Dre produces you, that's that ass. You know what I'm saying? You got dead ass hits. And also people like Britney Spears. Britney Spears, you know who's producing a lot of Britney stuff?
Probably Timberland or somebody. I don't know.
Timberland's on some of that stuff, but also remember Full Force?
Oh yeah.
Full Force.
Yeah, Bowlegged Lou and the crew.
Bowlegged Lou and them are still at bay, son. They still producing. Like, they're not out there like throwing a name out there, Full Force. But yo, I remember them from back in the day and Dan Satira, big props out to you guys, I'm serious, man. But yo, them boys are still in the lab creating hits, man. And I tell you what, it's a beautiful thing that we do have people who are musically apt and musically apt. And so they're putting tracks together and putting groove and sound together that people can not only dance to, but, you know, they got the hypnotics in the music, they got the commerciality in the music, and you know something, and they're trying to give us some substance. Britney, what's Britney's latest song? What's it called?
Hold it against me.
Yeah, she said, if I got a nice body, would you hold it? If you tell me you got a nice body, would you hold it against me? Yo, I mean, okay.
And that's actually the hook from a country song. Was a huge hit.
Come on, country and western, man. If you guys want a real laugh for how people are able to put some ironics into lyrics, you know, country western mums is fun. Rednecks is a funny mums.
Hey, but I'm going to tell you something, though. You know, bro, listen. Now, I live down south, and down south, you're going to get a taste of country music. And I'm going to tell you something. It's really white people's soul music. And if you listen to some of it's really, really awesome. And it releases something in your brain, because some of those country songs will make your ass cry. If you listen to them.
This is true. And last time I went to Tennessee, right? I went down to see my baby brother down at Thanksgiving. And, of course, my sister was there. Big props out to my sister, Nan Jeanette Delaney Collins.
What's up, big sis?
And yeah, happy birthday. She had a birthday, March the 8th on Women's Day for the Ruska and Chelovek. But also, it was like, you know, my sister.
Yeah,
birthday.
She looks younger than both of us.
Yo, show me saying that. Yeah, she does. You know, she's beautiful. And also, her daughter, Ariel, just had a birthday on the 12th, which was 2 days ago. Happy birthday, Ariel.
Yesterday was my mom's birthday.
Okay, your mom's birthday was yesterday. Happy birthday to your moms, okay? And also, and Mel Collins' birthday is the 15th. And Logan Delaney Sr., our older brother, you know, the entrepreneur from Delaney Capital Management. If you don't know, now you know. His birthday's on the 16th. Guys, we like to throw out birthdays. You got a birthday wish? You want to shout out birthday shout out? Be sure to give us a call.
Oh, the 19th is Bushido Brooklyn's birthday.
Okay, Bushido Brooklyn, bro. We're wishing you happy birthday early, Kent.
Woo!
You know what I'm saying? We love you
happy,
in the
happy,
his nizzle
happy,
here.
Happy,
you know,
happy, that's happy birthday.
That's it. So happy birthday. You know, and like I say, we wish each and every one of you to have a happy birthday. But more than that, guys, we want you guys to have a happy day. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And every day.
With the dopamine from the music.
That's what I'm saying. Listen to your music, guys, and bring in something good, man, to not just for yourself. Because once you get in a good mood, then you can help somebody else get in a good mood. Because there's a whole lot of